Okay, good afternoon, everyone. It's already 2 o'clock. Hello, Sir Pratyush.
Hello.
Yes, so welcome to the webinar themed an awareness campaign on financial markets. Our speaker for today is Mr. Pratyush Bhaskar, and he has also brought a colleague with him, Mr. Abhay Navgare, sorry. So, sir, on behalf of Tetzel College and the Department of Commerce and Management, I would like to extend our warmest welcome to you. So, before we begin the session, let me just give a brief introduction of our speaker. All right. So, Mr. Pratyush Bhaskar is a multilingual business broadcast journalist, financial trainer, and media consultant with over 20 years, mind you guys, 20 years of field experience on working and creating content for noted media houses like Zee Business, DD News, TV9, TV18, P7 News, UTV. These are just a few of the names, media houses that he has collaborated with. So, sir has also covered strategic key bits such as covering listing of companies in financial markets, product launches, mergers, acquisitions, and joint venture deals like Tata JLR, SEBI announcements. He has also interviewed RBI governor and IRDA regulator. So currently, Mr. Pratyush Bhaskar is associated with a media production house presenting India's first financial education news show called Paisa Vasool on the national broadcaster DD News. He has also conducted 500+ financial market seminars on behalf of SEBI, NSE, and NSDL in top companies, associations, colleges, schools, and institutions across India. So, in addition to this, sir has also been teaching banking, financial services, and insurance courses, plus journalism courses for this undergraduate and postgraduate students in colleges such as Mithibai, Somaiya, and Harikshan Mehta Institute of Media Research and Analysis. So, you guys, keep in mind, we have in our midst a very a multi-talented man, a man with abundance of experience, of skill and knowledge, and therefore I hope this session will be a benefit, will benefit each and every participant present here. And so, sir, welcome once again. Without further ado, please take the time.
Thank you so much, Tango. I think thank you so much for embarrassing me. Nobody has gone through my CV in that detail. I forgot what all I've done. Let me just, but really, thanks a lot. You've been very kind with your words, very polite. You know what? When you move ahead in life, you forget what's happening in the back, but then it's good to once in a while look back. Just a correction, that was the past 500. Now we've covered around 1,000 sessions. So Northeast is one such area, it's a happy hunting ground for, if I may say so, because that is one area a lot of people don't go. And I always feel like, you know, in today's time, I'll be very, very candid. You all students are grown up enough. I should not be trying to put up a, or rather sugarcoat what scenario we have right now in our Indian situation, isn't it? We've got three big issues in front of us. One is the sanitation crisis, that is Corona. The other is the economic depression that we are looking at. That happened even before Corona struck us, isn't it? And third very important thing is the China crisis that we have on the borders. So three C's, and I don't know how we look forward to get beyond it. We keep talking about what the others should do, but you know, being a reporter, I should better tell you, we are very good at that, telling people what people should do. We forget what we are doing actually. I hope you got the joke, what I'm trying to say. So jokes apart, today we will look into what we all can do on our part. Being students of finance, can we study this scenario in perspective and understand what we are studying is not just a 20, 25 mark paper, but can also change our life. The way economy of Dimapur, you know, your state is, you can change every damn thing, believe me. And these words are coming from someone who's a zoology graduate. I'm not lucky to have a professor like Day Sir. You are lucky people studying commerce. In our time, my dad, being a doctor, he said, no, nothing doing, only, you know, in our place in North India, we are told to study medical engineering or UPSC. Fourth thing is always considered time pass. So I trust me, you know, 90% of India doesn't understand importance of financial literacy, financial planning, which is very, very crucial for our survival. I would rather say financial planning is a life skill, because in today's time, our teachers taught life science was, you know, botany, zoology, but life, being the teacher, taught me life science means commerce and economics. So in today's time, if you don't understand both these subjects, then may God bless you. You won't survive for long, trust me. Look at how our states in north and how states like Gujarat, Rajasthan are faring. Don't you see a difference? Now, out there in Gujarat and Rajasthan, you've got only sand to bury your head just like an ostrich would do, seeing trouble. But no, those guys have got the whole of, you know, finance, the money, everything keeps pouring to their state. It doesn't go to our resource-rich state, North or Northeast, does it? Because we are not able to appreciate the finer financial details, isn't it? So today's session is going to be an eye-opener. I would keep it very, very practical because for theory, we've got wonderful professors like Desar and teachers are there. But I would just insist on telling you what all I've seen in my little span that I've been dabbling, if I may say so, with a lot of, you know, balance sheets of companies. I would rather say, you know, balance sheet is like Mills and Boons for we finance reporters. You can know about a company by having a look at the P&L numbers. And in today's time, almost every company is trying to cook books. You know, cooking books is a word we generally use for when somebody is trying to dabble with numbers. You know, we've seen so many accountancy frauds in the recent past. You saw what happened with Satyam. So a lot of things have happened around us. And anybody who says that finance, economics, commerce is boring, you should jump off the cliff. Trust me, you're not understanding. A science guy is saying, boss, whatever colors I found in botany, there are more colors on the balance sheet. Only thing you should be able to get through to it. So without further much ado, I won't bore you with the foundational part. I'll just dig deep into it since you guys are all hardcore finance students. Today, I will just run you through a presentation and I'll see if we can understand something about, you know, a crucial area like financial markets. Are you all able to see this slide? Is it visible?
Yes, sir. Now it's visible.
Yes, sir.
Great, great. So you see this particular building. Anybody who's been to Bombay shouldn't be unaware of this building. You might have come to Bandra for obvious other reasons. On Bandra West said you got all those funny film stars doing all funny businesses. You all have been seeing what's happening in the news channel. I need not get into it. On the Bandra East side, there's a place called Bandra Kurla Complex, BKC. If you ever been to this place, we call it the commercial hub right now. It's called the new Nariman Point because all the fort offices, big company offices, they've shifted to Bandra Kurla Complex. And one such office is Securities Exchange Board of India, SEBI. Now, if you all have heard about SEBI, you would know SEBI is an administrative body, a statutory body created by Government of India, Ministry of Finance, for one purpose. Now, before knowing that purpose, let me give you a 30-second small story about how SEBI came into being. You all remember the year 1992? Were you all born then? I presume your mom and dad were preparing for you to come in the world, I guess. So, jokes apart, what I'm trying to say is Buddha people like me and Desa, we were already alive. We saw what happened in 1982. There was this guy called Harshad Mehta. Now, Harshad Mehta was a very smart chap. You know what he used to do? He used to be an agent between two banks. Now, understand how banks work. You know, banks sometimes need some money to be given to the other bank. So he used to be basically an agent between two banks. So say on Friday, he'll get some tranche of money. And mind you, banks generally share money to the tune of lakhs and crores, not just 150 rupees, isn't it? So that much of liquidity coming to a person, imagine what he can do. So that time people were very smart, very simpletons. They didn't know what to do. This guy was a smart aleck. So what did he used to do? He knew about financial markets. So he used to use that liquidity to invest in stock market. And say by Monday when the bank opens, he will make decent returns because he had good knowledge of which stocks will go up, which stock will go down. And from there, he'll get the money that he had invested, the interest he'll pay to both the parties, whatever was due. Out of the remaining, the arbitrage that used to be his profit. And trust me, when you invest lakhs and crores, if you look at the volume game, your returns go into manifold, isn't it? Which means this was the game he was playing for quite a number of weeks, months. Suddenly, markets crashed. He was not able to provide whatever money he had taken from one bank to the other with the interest. So what happened? This scam came through. Banks were in tension. What has this bugger done to us? And then the story came out how he had frauded the whole system. In the year 1992, mind you, there was no SEBI. SEBI, people are talking about SEBI. So government got in tension. You know, government thought if we don't create this organization, people will have to go to their local police station. Now, police stations, you know, they don't understand about financial crime. They only know 354 molestation, 302 half murder and stuff like that. Financial crime, economic offense wing came later on. In the year 92, everything was very simple. People had no clue about financial markets. So, you know, government had to hasten, and in the year 1992, SEBI Act was promulgated and SEBI was put through. It was given whole charge of taking care of all the investors' interests. So small investors who think somebody can take them for a ride, because you know people think market is full of all sharks and big, you know, piranhas. To save your butt, you can go to SEBI. So SEBI was created as an administrative body. The purpose was any person, whether your mom and dad, uncle, aunt, whoever misses out on anything that you feel like somebody's trying to give for a ride, your savings is at a risk in being invested in the wrong company, you can always approach SEBI for information and also for redressal of your complaints. Okay. And there are certain numbers I'll be sharing, so I won't take much of your time. We'll just move ahead. Later on, I'll give you some numbers also, helpline numbers that you can call SEBI and get help from. Now, today we'll cover topics like financial planning, SEBI, buying, selling of share, mutual funds. And in case if you have any complaints, how to get your complaint redressed, we'll have that mechanism also understood. Now, the first topic that comes in front of us is financial planning. Have you all heard of financial planning? Anybody, let me give you another word. Family planning. Have you heard of family planning? Now, family planning is basically limiting number of children and family, isn't it? Financial planning is limiting financial liabilities in life. Financial liabilities means where areas where you are putting in money, but you're not getting good returns. Your money is going, not coming, isn't it? Now, financial liabilities doesn't mean you go home, tell your mom and dad or your great grandmom, granddad that, boss, you guys are not doing anything at all, only eating and shitting, we can't take care of you. Never ever think about that. No, never in 1,000 years. But I'm telling you, you know, it's a smart thinking. It's today we are here because of our family. Remember that. Our mom and dad, our granddad, grandmom, they've been helping us when we're not able even to stand. Financial planning never means disregarding our family values. Financial planning means planning for your future financial needs. And that can happen with family, isn't it? Look at America. They don't respect family values. You know what's happening to them. I mean, go on YouTube. You'll have too many reports coming through and they'll tell you what kind of mess they are in. Despite financial depression that we are right now looking eye to eye, still India is in a senior position. Why? Because we understand who all we are with right now, isn't it? So I would say financial planning means planning for your future financial needs. Today you all are students, mom, dad, they're able to take care of you. Tomorrow when they retire, you know, you have a family, you go ahead, you might have to take care of yourself. So what mom, dad are doing to us, tomorrow you'll have to do to your kids, isn't it? So financial planning is a cyclical process. I'll understand, we'll tell you how the cycle works. Now, in financial planning, we've got terms like money. Anybody who knows what is money? Money. Money is something that Mr. Mukesh Ambani has and my father doesn't. Anybody with more creative answers? Okay, some people would say money is something that is a medium of exchange, isn't it? That's what DESA teaches you in the books. Now, that is right, it is. But beyond that, can you think about something else? Let me give you another example. You see the statement, it's written there, money doesn't buy happiness. It gives us choices in life. Do you agree to the statement? Now, some people would disagree. People, what do we think? Money can buy happiness. You can buy anything with money, isn't it? That's what people think. Actually, we are mistaking choices to be happiness. I'll give you a small example. Say, you know, typical example of we guys, isn't it? It's not just your story, it's my story, it's every guy's story. Say on a birthday, generally we wake up very late in the day, you know, 10 o'clock, and dad, mom puts a bucket of water. Go, use this fellow, go to your college. You know, people are waiting for your exams are there. Then you go watch it. I'm sorry, I was playing video game all night, I couldn't get up and all. Birthday, you'll get up very early. Why? To coax and cajole your dad for some extra allowances, isn't it? Only birthday. Now you get up, you see your sister say, ah, lousy fellow, today you're getting up early. Isn't it just for getting extra moolah from dad? Don't worry, he remembers that you honked his bike. Whatever, the, you know, home jokes are all about. You would say, move off. Today's my day, I'll go talk to dad. You go talk to dad, you'll say, dad, today's a big day, you know. Dad will say, yeah, son, I remember today only I did a huge blunder many, many years back. And every year to this day, you keep reminding me of my mistakes. I'm just joking. But sometimes, you know, that's what happens with fathers and how, that's how we talk. You say, dad, enough of this Kapil Sharma jokes, be serious. You're supposed to give me some gift, right? Dad says, yeah, I remember every year I give you some 5,000-10,000 rupees for doing nothing at all. What more do you want? You'd say, dad, it seems you're not reading your newspapers properly. Look at it, you know, everything is becoming very costly by the day. Inflation is going up. You will try to, you know, put up your case strongly. Dad will say, look, son, your granddad gave me that bicycle. I gave you a bike. Nothing beyond that. You say, no, dad, you know what? Even my office boy, he comes in a bullet. I need a KTM. Which means you're not coming to your point. Now, if dad says, nothing doing, son, you know what's happening to the economy, my salary appraisal hasn't come through, whatever might be the reason. So what happens is, in case if you're able to coax and cajole dad and get money, you'll have options in life, isn't it? You can go for KTM, Duke, Harley Davidson, Bullet at the fag end. And if that doesn't give you the money, you might have to go for Hero Honda Passion, for which you don't have any passion at all, isn't it? Which means with money, we are getting choices in life. What we do with our choice will make us happy or sad, isn't it? Look at what it says. What we do with a choice will make us happy or sad. Let's say dad gives you some money. He's in a very good mood. And you use that money to open a mutual fund account. Put money in mutual fund. Do you think your money will grow? In case if you come into the words of one of your smart friends just like you and say, you know what, forget mutual fund, 2-3%, what is the return? Come, I know one of my friends, he's into this marketing, that marketing. Your money will quadruple overnight. And out of greed, you put your money there. Will your money grow? Your money will not grow. It will go. In grow, R stands for returns. Returns becomes mute, grows becomes goes. So always remember, if somebody is trying to sugarcoat deal to you, this means there are red flags out there. Remember, there's nothing called easy money. Money is like a seed. You can put that seed under in between your teeth, crush it, get some taste out of it, the rest pass out to a stool. And if you put that seed in soil, a plant comes out, a sapling comes out, that plant becomes a tree. Tree will have fruits, fruits will have again seeds, seeds you can drop somewhere else. And this cycle, if you proceed with this cycle, this is how money should grow. We call in our technical language, power of compounding, isn't it? So money should always be used as seed, not as a nut, by a nut cracked somewhere else, isn't it? So you use money to develop it, to make it grow. And if you buy things that you do not need, soon you'll have to sell things that you need. It's what elders say, which is quite right. Which means in today's time, college might teach you how to earn money, but you should also learn how to manage your money. If you don't know how to manage your money, then may God bless you. You have to manage your money, because people like Ratan Tata, Mukesh Ambani, Kumar Mangala, Birla, they all have made so much money, not just because of their businesses they are in, but they know how to manage their money, isn't it? So you also understand how you can manage your money. In managing money, there are two terms we come across, savings, investment, isn't it? What is savings? What is investment? You all know. I want to know the difference. Anybody who knows the difference between these two? Let me give you another small example. We journalists are good storytellers. I would tell everything through a story, okay? If that's okay with you. Say you go to your, after you talk to your dad, you go to your mom. You tell mom, dad is again trying to not give me money. Mom will say, come, aaja mera laal, mera kala pila raju bhi hai. That's how, you know, mom pampers us. So mom will go to the kitchen. She won't go to the bank, by the way. Mom is home ministry. Dad is external affairs ministry, isn't it? So foreign affairs, everything dad takes care of. Mom will go to the kitchen. She won't go to the bank. She'll open her flower box. In goes hand, out come 2,000 rupees note, isn't it? Now this magic only moms can create. Dads, it's the other way around. The moment this money goes to dad's hand, because he's got nutcases like us kids, what we do is we latch on to dad, I want this money. And dad would say, okay, out of his love and affection, give us the money. And money doesn't grow. In case, again, out of the love and affection that he has for us, he might put that money in some scheme. Without realizing whether a scheme is good or not, he'll go to his one of his friend. That friend will be as smart as he is, but he'll say, you know what, one of my brother-in-law came from blah 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 this place, and this is how it is, and money will grow because this person got the return. So without doing any research, he invests, money doesn't grow, it goes, isn't it? So in today's time, just to understand, mom keeps that money in her flat box, isn't it? But she knows there's a mouse going around in the kitchen. The mouse is called inflation. Inflation eats into the savings that we have, isn't it? So what mom does is she puts some part of that savings to dad, and she says, you know what, our son is growing. Why don't you put this money in some scheme? Dad will go talk to one of his smart friends just like him. They say, you know what, put the money here. And with due respect to our dads, they are not finance students. They don't understand how money grows, you know, how wealth management is to be done. And that also we don't realize. So my request is, whenever you've got time, whatever you study from DESER, whatever you study from your books, please share with your parents. Because understand, in today's time, the kind of effort we all put in earning our money, if we put even 10% of that in managing the money, God may bless us. We'll grow money like anything, isn't it? That's what people who are at the other end of wealth spectrum are doing. We are not, isn't it? So today I would say, please think about how you can convert your savings into investment. Now, there the catch lies. I'll give you another example. So your sister, you never give her money on Raksha Bandhan, mind you. Nobody does. We put money to our girlfriend, isn't it? Anyways, one fine day you've given some money to your sister. Your sister puts that money in the piggy bank, isn't it? That's what girls do. Nice piggy bank. You put the money in the piggy bank for 10 long years. Girls are good at, you know, they can save money like anything. Guys can spend like anything. That's what we are infamous for, isn't it? So you put money in piggy bank for 10 long years. If you put money in piggy bank, will the money grow on its own? Will the money decrease on its own? Or will the money remain the same? Anybody? most of you would think money will remain the same, isn't it? Money will never grow. That we all, it's a no-brainer. How about money decreasing? Think about it. See, as I said, in the case of mom, she puts money in the flower box. Same here in the piggy bank, money stays there. The face value of money remains the same, but purchasing power of money goes down, isn't it? You have to realize that money, whatever it could buy 10 years back, can it buy today? No, it can't. The value of money has gone down because things around us are becoming costlier by the day. So in today's time, mere savings won't help you. Imagine if you have that particular money, and that money, this piggy bank is a smart piggy bank, a piggy bank with four different compartments. How? Four different compartments are debt, equity, commodity, property. Have you all heard of debt? Debt is when you put your money in banks, fixed deposits, liquid funds, isn't it? Insurance, that is debt. Equity is capital markets, stock market, shares, some equity mutual funds. Then commodities, gold, bullion, and the other commodities. Property, real estate that we all know. So if you're smart enough and you don't doze off in day sales class and you're listening to everything about finance, and if you know how much of 10,000 should go in debt because you need some safety also. Since you are young, you got 30 years of ahead in front of you, you can work. You put maximum amount of an equity because equity is a long-term investment instrument, mind you. Then since you're a girl, you love buying some gold jewelry and all that. So if you put some money in gold and Bangla Banega Naya, you want to have a nice house also, you put some money for real estate. If you invest your money accordingly, don't you think your money will grow? Which means what money you're putting in the piggy bank, smart piggy bank, the smart piggy bank is giving you equal amount of more money, or rather even more than that, if you're smart enough. Which means this smart piggy bank is what? It's actually a mutual fund. Mutual fund gives you best of both the worlds, or rather all the worlds, isn't it? I will tell you how mutual fund helps you in subsequent slides. So this is how, what we do is we convert our savings into investment. We all are trying to convert a piggy bank into a smart piggy bank. If we do it, we can increase our money manifold, isn't it? Now, what happens to our savings and investment? If you put your money underneath a pillow in a piggy bank, your money doesn't grow, as you all know, isn't it? It's household savings, that's what we call it. But if you put your money in some company, you invest in some shares, the company uses the money to grow, isn't it? If the company grows, the GDP grows. GDP grows, the country grows, isn't it? Let me give you this example another way. Say you and I have got some money. We have got money, but we don't know what to do with the money. So what we do, we tell Mr. Tata, not literally, but say we are talking to him. Say, Mr. Tata, you know what? I've got some money. I don't know what to do with the money. I think you know what to do with your money. How about I give me my money to you and please use it in your company. I am investing in your company and please make it grow. So since Mr. Ratan Tata specializes in converting, loss making profit like telco into profit making one that he did, he, all along his life, he's been doing that, isn't it? So all these businesses, you have to first do your research, and in share market, that's exactly what you do. You give the money to the companies that boss invest on my behalf. Huh, but I would expect good dividend at the end of every quarter, every, annual AGM and all that. But that is between you and the company. You'll be always asked about your opinion. In the AGM, you are required to do that. So stock market is a scenario wherein, you are giving your money to someone who knows how to use it. But there lies a catch. You should always be particular about your research. Never follow borrowed gyan. If I'm giving you some knowledge, you should do this. Never. See, whenever you borrow, with borrowing comes an interest. Remember that. Interest can go both ways, isn't it? So my request is, do your own research. If a zoology guy can do research, boss, you people are all, sons and daughters of finance, isn't it? You can do pretty much better than that with your teachers. Now, when we have money, we use money for our financial well-being, isn't it? Financial well-being would be using money for further studies, for marriage. Without money, can you marry? Talk to your girlfriend, she'll tell you, better idea. Buying house, if you want to buy a nice fancy house anywhere in Dimapur, you need money. Retirement, boss, in today's time, if I'm working like a maniac, if I don't have a retirement plan, I'm in deep trouble, isn't it? Another very important aspect, health emergencies. No other example, look at Corona. Today, if somebody somebody says that he's tested positive, what tension that person is in, because once you go to the hospital, you might be given a huge bill. Now, India has got world-class healthcare, we all know. But for every world-class healthcare, we've got world-class bill also. Doctors can save you from the diseases. Who will save you from the bills? To save yourself from the bill, you need to go for health insurance. Mind you, whenever you start earning, my request is a small one, whatever, an optimum one. Don't go for a fancy insurance, but some insurance is required. If you don't understand, when we start earning, the first thing we should think about is our protection. First, when we earn, we have to save. Savings need. It's for daily needs, short-term goals. Say you're come out of your house. Mom says, you know what, son, today kitchen is shut. You'll have to go out, take the money, have some, you know, snacks, which means that is a short-term goal. Say day seven is an examination, Monday or whichever day, you know, you're supposed to buy some stationery for that. That will be your short-term goals. Then comes protection needs. Protection need, I told you, you're crossing a road. There's a truck on from the, you're coming from the other side. You saw the truck didn't see you on the lower end. You know what happens next? You are in the hospital, dad in tension. Doctor says, you know what, this much of money, operation successful. If the money is not there, may God bless your son, isn't it? So in today's time, anything can happen to anyone. So my request is first get an insurance done. I'm not saying a fancy one, but at least an optimum family floater is very much required because nobody knows what will happen next. Then comes investment needs. You all have a dream. We all have a dream. We want to become something, isn't it? When I was your age. So that leads us to our medium-term, long-term goals. Say you want to get into revenue services. You want to become an MBA. Isn't it? You want to become whatever. You become a chartered accountant, a company secretary. For that would become your long-term goal. To fulfill your these goals, you've got different ways of investing or rather saving. Savings bank is there, RD is there, post office bank, money market, liquid mutual fund, ultra short-term funds, bond, debentures, shares, mutual fund, pension plans and provident fund. So you have to decide where you want to put your money. Options are all available, but first get the knowledge about each of these and then start investing. Whenever we tell people to invest either money or time, they say, boss, we don't have any of them. Time, I don't believe. Money, I can believe. Money you're not having because you don't know how to save money, isn't it? So let me show you this example with these two equations. Look at these two equations, the first equation and the second equation. The first equation is of our household expenditure. This is ghar ghar ki kahani, Ekta Kapoor style, isn't it? In our house, what happens? Dad comes on first of every month or first week, whenever he gets his salary, we latch on to him, isn't it? Dad, money, money. Dad would say, son, just hang on. Let me talk to your mom also. You know, household expenditure also needs to be taken care of. You know, your kitchen expenses, everything. Your sister comes running. She wants anything, poor chap, but she's sitting in one corner. She needs some money for studies. So what happens? Dad divides all the money amongst each one of us. After dividing for our expenses, if there's some money left, that becomes savings. This is a typical household story, isn't it? You know how Mr. Mukesh Ambani, people like Ratan Tata, Kumar Mangalam Birla, how they work? They work in a different way. They come to their house, say Mr. Mukesh Ambani will come to his house. He'll say, Neeta Ben, tame kya chho, yahan beso. That's how they talk in Gujarati, right? So he'll say, see, this much of, you know, Jio SIM card or whatever work from home has happened. So I've made a lot of money. I've sold a lot of my stake to his Facebook and all that. So this month, I've got this much of money. So he'll say, this is my monthly earnings. From this, I'm removing my savings first. So Mr. Mukesh Ambani is smart. He knows the importance of savings. So what he does is he removes a part of his income as savings. And from the remaining of his income, he says, do whatever you feel like. Either you want to go buy an IPL team, have a ball, whatever you want to do, do. But you're not supposed to touch savings. And this is the reason why Mr. Mukesh Ambani is Mukesh Ambani, Ratan Tata. They're all rich. Our father is not rich because he's got NPAs, non-performing asset like us, isn't it? We keep latching onto him. So today when dad comes, whenever first of the month dad comes, I just tell him, dad, there's this guy in our webinar, he bored us dead alive, whatever. But he gave us a nice idea. He said, from now on, whenever you bring your salary, we are not going to take everything from you. What we do is from your salary, please remove a part of your salary as savings. From the remaining money, I've talked to mom also, we will manage within the remaining only. If you do this for a couple of months, couple of years, believe me, whether or not you become Mr. Mukesh Ambani, Ratan Tata, that's completely up to your destiny or your hard work. But for sure, you will have a strong savings, isn't it? And once you've got a strong savings, you can, with your knowledge, understanding of different asset classes, you can invest. So my request is learn how to save. And these two equations, you know, have been taken from a book called Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Read that book. That book has been written by a guy called Robert Kiyosaki. Please read him. We call him Financial Samurai. That guy is an amazing person. He's got amazing ideas about gold. He says, you know, I don't believe in any currency. I only believe in God-created currency, that's gold and silver. So that's one way of looking at it. But you know what? When you invest in gold, you don't get regular returns. You only get returns when you sell the gold at the end, isn't it? You can manage, you can think about it. Otherwise, there are a couple of equity products which have gold as the underlying asset, like gold ETF. You can think about that also. That we'll talk in the later slides. But first up, when we talk about financial planning, we need to understand you have to follow a flowchart. The first step in financial planning is identifying your goals. Now, if I ask any one of you, all the Tetsuites, do you have any goal in life? Any dream? What do you dream about? Not the girl sitting next to you. She can come only when you've got something, you know. Even Bill Gates got Melinda Gates because only when he opened his windows which will yield sack full of currency note, whichever country he goes, isn't it? You also need to think about having a goal in life. Steve Jobs, He taught us he can sell his half-eaten apple at a far greater price than one kg of apple, isn't it? Look at how costly Apple machines are. Anyways, and look at the Apple logo. You'll get the joke. Okay, jokes apart, what I'm trying to say is have a goal in life. There's a guy called Ratan Tata. I've been naming him amazing. He has said a very nice thing. You should always have a goal in life. Have a dream in life. If you don't have a goal or dream in your life, somebody else will have a goal or dream in their life. And that person will hire you for fulfilling their own dreams, not yours. Would you like that? Would you like that? Tell me. Somebody else having all the goals. And that's exactly what is happening. Mr. Ratan Tata, Mr. Mukesh Ambani, Mr. Dhirubhai Ambani had a dream. Karlo dunia mutthi mein. Didn't he do that? And we all, our parents, you know, our uncle, aunt, they are working for those people because they had a dream, our uncle, aunt didn't. So in today's time, my request is have a goal in life. Today, I want that, you know, Nagaland should get one of their, you know, Flipkart or Amazon or Microsoft Windows from you people only. Tetsuo College is an amazing college. You know, you got a fantabulous promoter of yours, one who knows mutual fund. I met him last time when I was there. So I would suggest you got right people. Daysar is there. Just eat his head hollow. Learn, download everything from his, you know, hard disk. We all need to learn that. That's what I used to do in my class. Everybody was very afraid of me because I used to ask a lot of questions. Today, I did do the same thing being a reporter. But trust me, answering the questions is a far bigger fun because then I also learn a lot. Your generation is smartphone generation. Our generation was Nokia 1100 generation, isn't it? So I would suggest phones have become smart, but we all have become dumb. We need to become far more smarter. How? By having a nice goal in life. So my request is have a goal. Like, Bill Gates, you know Bill Gates' story? He was not in Tetsuo, mind you. He was in which college? He was in Harvard, London. He was studying maths. So he used to having some pumped up device. That time there was no mobile phone, mind you. So math teacher saw, just like Daysar is there, so math teacher was very strict. He said, Bill, what are you doing in my class? Now, Bill, you know, he's got a very nice sense of humor. So he said, he thought, if I stay here, I've got a Harvard ka thappa, will it help me in getting a job? Will it help me achieving my goals? He said, sir, I'm playing video games. Now, for all you people who know Bill Gates, before starting Microsoft Windows, he used to write HTML codes. He's very good at coding, mind you. That's the reason he started at company. Same with Zuckerberg. He's very good at coding. That's why Facebook came through when he was very young. So, Mr. Bill Gates said, I'm playing video games. Hearing that, teacher got furious. He said, Bill, playing video games in my class? Bill, out of the gates. Now, before Bill went out of the gates, didn't he open Windows? He did, because he knew whether or not I finished my education here, the Windows that I'll open will help me in getting sack full of currency notes. Today, you know, he puts 50-60% of his earning into charity, still is among the top 10 richest person. Which means he has taught one thing to all of us, that you don't make money by snatching it from people's hands. Politicians, please learn. Okay, you can also make money by being charitable. But for that, you need to open windows, isn't it? That was just a joke. What I'm trying to say is, in today's time, we need to have a goal in our life, a dream in life. And once you have a goal in life identified, the next step is identifying your assets. Who are our assets? Our assets are our mom and dad, isn't it? For non-performing assets, NPAs like us, only they are the saviors. If you think you've got a nice idea, you want to convert that idea into Airtel, Vodafone, Hutch, please go to a bank. Try going for one of those Mudra fancy loans that government has promised. The manager would say, son, come here. Have you seen your face in the mirror? I don't see any reason why I should put my money. Your idea is a hokum pokum piece out of the window. Nobody will believe you. But you know, our mom and dad, they're always there to support us. So for assets, first assets are a mom and dad. Then you have to identify your liabilities. I would call responsibilities. See, you've got a younger sibling. Then you don't take money from them. You pay them because that's what your responsibility is. Which means here you have to pay back. Then once you start working, you'll have a nice future earning, isn't it? That's exactly what will happen to you. And once you'll have an earning, you'll have spending also. So in your life, remember two things will happen. You'll earn, you'll spend. If your earning is more than your spending, balle balle, you're very happy. If your earning is less than your spending, you'll be in trouble, isn't it? So to make up for that, either you have to increase your earnings, but there's a limit to which you can increase your earnings. There's a limit to which you can decrease your spending also. You can't stop eating. So there is a limit which you can't extend both of these. Suppose that what you do is, whatever money you're getting, you should plan. Whatever pocket money dad mom is giving you, please put that money in suitable products. We call it investment. Putting money in suitable products. What are suitable products? For your age will be mini mutual funds like SIP, systematic investment planning, SIP. So my request is, moment the session is over, don't open your video game again, because I want you to understand your life is a real video game where you have to be the real hero or a villain, whichever way you work as. So please open Google or any of the website, go to nsindia.com, go to SEBI website, check out all the details that they have to provide. Check out about mutual funds, study about them, because the exchange and the regulator, they've got storehouse of information on their websites. Problem is, if I ask you honestly, put your hand on your heart, cross it, and say, how many of you have visited these websites? I don't know whether you have. My request is the books that you're studying, they are from Baba Adam Ke Zamane Se, isn't it? Very old. Despite the best efforts, books take ages to get reprinted and corrected and all that. Right now, things are happening at a rocket speed in front of us, isn't it? Things are changing. So my request is, internet is a huge storehouse of knowledge. Please learn from it. Go to the website of NSAB. And very important, when we invest, review. You should review. If you're putting money in debt, equity, commodity, property, if your money is not coming good enough from debt, switch to equity. Equity is not giving it a switch to commodity. You should always keep reviewing your investments. If you don't, remember, investment is a dynamic process, not static. You've done it, done and dusted, you don't look at it. No. You look at how the markets are changing. And based on that, make your decisions. Now, I'll just run through the rest of the slides, which are quite long, but then they are theoretical because many of this you've already studied in your classes. One is diversification. When we invest, remember, you should diversify your risk. You should become risk averse. How do you become risk averse? By investing part of your investment into bonds, CDs, mutual funds, stocks. Asset allocation is also very important. What it means is basically apportioning your money in various products, which means like fixed income, growth, you know, tax savers and equities and cash. It all depends what your investment horizon, investment, you know, avenues. What are you thinking? Always remember, you have to think about your goal first. Everybody has a different goal. Somebody would have a goal of saying having good retirement. Okay, somebody will want to go abroad. Somebody want to have higher studies. Whatever your goal is, please invest accordingly. Okay, and don't copy people. When we invest, there are three important considerations for any product. What are these three important considerations? The first is returns. Then comes safety, liquidity. I'll just run you through some of these in with some speed. Returns is like, say, for instance, if I tell one of your CRs, you know what, I'm giving you 100 rupees. Give me 100 rupees. End of this month, I'll give you 150 rupees. Won't you be happy? If I say, give me 100 rupees, I'll give you 120 rupees, 101 rupees, you'll be not very happy. If I say, give me 100 rupees, I might or might not give you money, but 90 rupees you'll get. Will you be happy? You'll say, run away, I don't give you money. So it's basically dependent on returns. If your returns are not good, you won't invest. Then comes safety. Say, for instance, if I talk to you, CR, I say, you know what, take 10 rupees from all the students. Now, 10 rupees is something that each one of you can spare, say for a tea and whatever, isn't it? Now, if I take 10 rupees from 100 people, it becomes how much? 1,000. From 1,000, if I take 10 rupees, become 10,000. From 10,000, lakh to 10 lakh, 10 lakh to 1 crore. Now, to 10 lakh people, 10 rupees is a small measure. But for a person, single person like me, 1 crore will be enough. Now, I'm trying to show that I'm a conscientious trader. What I say, I'm going to buy seeds with your money. And I'll say, for every 10 rupees invested, I'll return 90 rupees, which means 100 rupees you'll get. Now, 9 times return will make anybody's mouth water. And I'd say, I'm investing, I'm going to buy seeds. I plant the seeds on both sides of, say, from Dimapur to Guwahati. And you'll have a nice avenue. 10 years, the trees will grow. You know how much it rains. A bald person like me stands there, bloody, you know, hair on my scalp. That much it rains. So if trees, plants are put there, seeds are put there, for sure they'll have plants, trees. I say 10 years, I sell all the fruits, the wood, whatever comes out. And for every 10 rupees I invest, you invest, I get you 90 rupees extra. Won't you be happy? We call it environment-friendly investment plan. You'll be happy. Do you want to give me money? Come on, give the money to your CR. This is exactly how, you know, plantation schemes work. I'm just kidding, don't do that. I'm just saying this is how, you know, people come and make nice fancy presentations to you and you start thinking, oh, Rose Valley, nice name. It has a ring to it, isn't it? Which means in today's time, anybody can take you for a ride. My only question is, when you listen to me, first of all, Dave sir knows about me, he's done my background check. You should always do a background check on everybody. What is the agency, company, and every damn thing. Before putting your hands into your pocket, please put your fingers on your head and think what I'm saying, what this person is trying to sell me. Is he trying to sell something which is not good? And if you see a single red flag, run away. Run away. Don't even wait for it. And please inform others to say from people like me if I'm doing something funny, isn't it? Then comes liquidity. Liquidity is, say, if you put money in gold in a jeweler and they says, you know what, you have to finish filling your admission form by this weekend. And you go to a jeweler, say, you know, I need the money back. Come on, give me my money back. You say, you know, son, I have to go to Guwahati, get the thing liquidated. By next Monday, I'll give you the money. Will you be happy? You won't. So whenever you invest money, you want your investment to be liquid, which means whenever you want, you should get the money back ASAP. Okay? And the degree of investment differs from person to person. For somebody, returns might be more important. Somebody's safety might be more important. People at my age, I would prefer safety, isn't it? Because I don't have many years left now for investing. But people at your age might be thinking returns is more important. Safety you can take care of, isn't it? Now, when we invest, we have to keep in mind this risk-reward matrix. What is this risk-reward matrix? If the reward is high, risk will be high. This happens in the case of derivatives, equity, stock products, isn't it? If the rewards are low and risk is low, it happens. If risk is low, reward will also be low. This happens in the case of bank deposits, post office savings, PPF, debt-oriented mutual funds, isn't it? Where your reward is high and risk is low. Remember, I'm saying reward is very high, risk is low. I'm saying give me money, I'll double, quadruple your money like this in a jiffy. Remember for this, SEBI, what SEBI has to say. SEBI says, such product do not exist. Don't believe if I say such a thing. I'm trying to sell you something which doesn't exist at all. Now, if risk is high and reward is low, in such cases, again, SEBI says, schemes promising unrealistic returns, where capital itself might perish, beware, which means your principal amount, that can also vanish. Remember, when we invest money, there's a small thing that we all are taught by elders. You should always have your corpus, the money that you have, invested in some debt product, because debt, there's a lot of safety feature with debt products. So you put your money there. Whatever returns you get from the debt product, 3-4%, please use that money investing elsewhere. In case, by saying that, if you do that, whatever happens to your riskier investment, at least your debt will remain in your hand. But if you invest the whole of it out of greed, what if the market crashes? Your money can vanish in thin air. So it's always advisable you should invest composedly. Have some money in debt, equity, commodity, property. That means your money will grow. Okay? Diversification is key. Now, when we talk about investments, people generally have a horizon. Say, for instance, if I say you have to develop a corpus of 10 lakh rupees, and if you are starting with some money, if I ask you to get a corpus of 10 lakh rupees, how soon should you start? There's an answer. If you start 30 years back, like right now, if you start studying, if you start investing for the age of 60, and if your power of compounding is 15%, if you do research, at this much of interest rate, these many years back, if you start investing, you will only require this much of money to be invested regularly for 30 years every month to get a corpus of 10 lakh rupees. But if you're investing, say, just 5 years back with this much rate of interest, you have to invest this much of money, isn't it? Which means if you start early, you always get a head start. So it's advisable. There's nothing, no time better than now to start investing. Don't wait, because if you wait, you might lose the head start. Okay, when we invest money, we always have two options. Either we invest on our own or we need a financial advisor. Now, choice is completely yours. If you think you're a big guy, you understand markets, you know investing, you can start investing on your own if you research well. But if you have got not much of knowledge, please visit a financial advisor. This is just like if you have some, diagnostic features of your suddenly getting breathless, temperatures going up. You can go to a medicine shop, get some medicine for fever, or you can go for your test done for corona, isn't it? So my request is, if you fall ill, should you go to a quick? Should you go to some medicine shop and get some medication done, self-medication done, or should you go to a doctor? My request is, please visit a doctor. In the same way, if you are not having proper knowledge, visit a financial advisor. But remember, there's a difference between financial advisor and the agent. Agent would be a person from a company who would be with the only idea they have is he would try to sell his product, only his products. Okay. A financial advisor is a neutral person who would first look at your financial profiling. He will have a clear understanding of your financial situation, your goals, explain how you can reach, what are your spending habits, how many people are in your family. And after asking all these many questions, he'll pay your financial profile. And then he'll say, please invest this much of your investment surplus that you have in this much in debt, this much in equity or market property. Because he has done that research. And for that, if he charges you money, you can pay him. But remember, if an agent is giving you free advice, remember that time the advice might be free, but you might have to pay later on, isn't it? Which means you are being sold somewhere. So remember, if something is free, doesn't mean that thing is good for you. And if somebody charges you, doesn't mean that thing is bad for you. It's completely how you decide, how you judge them after going through various parameters. When we invest, remember, investment is not gambling. You always keep saying that. People think it's gambling. It's not. There is a science and there are science in the stock market. You have to study both these things, isn't it? Now, when you see suddenly price by earning ratio PBE going up, you know when to exit, isn't it? Now, if you see at today's market, I mean, how the market is behaving these days, no production in the market, suddenly you see market going up. Now, you know there's something happening behind the scene, isn't it? So my request is, please study the market well. Don't consider it to be gambling. You should know where you're going with your investment, what you're dealing with. Study the products in advance. And for doing all these, we've got a nice, very investor-friendly regulator called SEBI. What does SEBI do? Let me run you through some data. SEBI is like a financial regulator. For investment products, the way you've got RBI in banking, we've got IRDA in insurance, like we've got PFRDA in pension, and forward markets commission we've got in commodities derivatives. So we've got a regulator in all these various areas. So what is the bottom line? You should always go in an area only when you have a regulator there. It's like, you know, going in a nice place and you say, oh, it's a nice Ram Rajya. There's no burglary, nobody steals anything. You're very happy. But God forbid, if tomorrow there's a burglary, who will you go and file complaints to? So it's always advisable to go in a market where there's a nice regulator. Equity market has a nice regulator called SEBI. It's been working right from the year 1992. As I told you, Harshad Mehta, you should thank him. Because we had Harshad Mehta, we got SEBI. Today, people like Sahara and all, they can't run with the money. You know what has happened with Subrata Sahara? He did the same thing. He was running a huge scam. SEBI rounded them off. They said, boss, you have to return the money. They couldn't. Right now, poor chap is in the jail. And all his hotels have been liquidated. And the money has been returned, is being returned to all the depositors as we speak. Now, there's a preamble to SEBI Act. The purpose is investor protection, regulation of securities market, and development of securities market, which all are very, very crucial. Okay. Now, under the purview of SEBI, we have got three I's, as we call them. They are investors, issuers, intermediaries. Investors would be people like you and me who want to benefit from the market by investing some of our savings. Issuers will be company which would want to raise money, capital from public through IPOs and all. Intermediaries would be stock exchanges, depositories, mutual fund, collective investment schemes. Again, this is a very ill-understood topic, so I would suggest keep away from CIS. Portfolio managers, stock brokers, depository participants, merchant bankers. These are intermediaries through which people like you and me, we invest in stock market. And through them, only these companies raise capital. Okay? So it's a win-win situation for all. Now, when we talk about securities market, so many questions come to our mind. Share, how to buy a share, do's and don'ts, bonds, debenture, mutual fund, rights, responsibilities, what is the procedure requirement? We'll run through them just in a jiffy. Okay. Now, we keep getting confused with terms like securities, equity, debt. Now, let me tell you, all securities, all equity are debt. Sorry, all equity are securities, but all securities are not equity. How? In securities, you've got debt, you've got CIS as well, which means the three forms of security. What is secure? Security is basically a paper that says that you own a particular asset class product at particular time unit at this price. And there's always a time value of money. Remember that. This price can change. Doesn't mean it's written there 10 years later, you'll be liable to get this money back. No, no. It will happen at that opportune time at whatever price that security is marketed at. Okay. Now, in securities, we've got equity, shares, warrants, mutual fund, ETF, derivatives. Debt, we've got government securities, bonds, debentures, mutual fund. Mutual fund are two type members. There are debt mutual fund. There are some equity mutual funds also. CIS, I told you, still not very clear. So stay from there. Okay. In securities market, what are securities market? Just to understand, it's a place where things are bought and sold, just like in any other market. Only thing, here you are buying securities. Securities like a contract paper, I told you. Okay, now this is a market where you've got participants, agents, entities, products, and best thing is it's regulated by SEBI. Okay, now why do we invest in securities market? There's a reason behind it. Your money grows, there's capital growth, you get good returns. Okay, you got diversification. I mean, you can diversify your investment, tax benefits are there. Just to make this form of investment more popular, government has, you know, doled out a lot of tax benefits. When you invest in debt, remember there are a lot of taxation there. But in equity, benefits are there if you invest for a longer term. Returns, as I told you, there are better returns. I will show you how. Look at this particular chart. If you, a lot of people, when you tell them that you got some money, what do you want to do? You would say, I'll put money in bank. Now, bank used to be safe till two people came in this world. Who are those two people? Neeraj Modi and Vijay Mallya, isn't it? Till they were not around, we used to consider bank very safe. And then in the year 2017, if I'm not wrong, there's a bill called FRDI bill.
I would suggest all students to Google it out. FRDI bill is a bill passed by Government of India, which says that if you put some money in the bank and God forbid for whatever reason, Neera Modi, Vijay Mallya, they ran away with your money, whoever people like them, then you are only supposed to get 10% or 1 lakh, whichever is lower, from your deposits. Which means in today's time, if you think putting money in banks, it's not considered as safe as it was before, isn't it? Because a lot of scams are happening. And even if your bank is a good, decent enough, your neighborhood bank, look what's happening to your money. You're putting 1 lakh rupees, you are getting interest 4,000 rupees, it becomes this much, but the tax on interest that you're somehow discounting is coming to this much. Impact of inflation. I told you what is inflation. Inflation is the rate at which products, services around us are becoming costlier by the day, isn't it? Which means you have to pay this much also on your money. This is the value by which your money has gone down, which means end of the year, your 1 lakh becomes 94,764. You won't realize it because you're not taking these two into account, isn't it? So my request is, boss, the days of banking are over. You have to think beyond it. So debt ke baad it comes equity. Now, when why do we do in equity or commodity property? Because diversification is there. As your Desa would be teaching you, don't put all eggs in a single basket. You know what happens next? They all will break, and without making you have a huge omelette, it will come on your face and it will stink like anything, isn't it? And you won't like it. Which means it's always good to become risk averse. Invest across different asset classes. This benefit you get in equity market. Now look at the tax benefits you get when you invest in different schemes. If you're investing in shares, remember if you invest for a long term, there's no capital gains. But for short term, there's 15%. If you're trading, buying and selling regularly, you'll have to pay a part of your profits to the government. Equity mutual fund, again, another form of investment, dividend tax free. Remember, dividends are taxed by the companies which are providing dividend. We call it dividend distribution tax, but you don't have to pay any tax on dividend. Remember that, okay? Again, long-term capital gain tax is nil. Debt mutual funds are there. Here also you've got some benefit, but then since debt is there, there's a component of tax here. Okay, ELSS. Now, this is something that people like me, Day Sir, we all love, isn't it? Because we all salaried people, we think about this. Why? Because it provides ATC rebate to us, isn't it? But problem is, I would suggest, you know, anybody who thinks of tax savings by investing, I would say tax savings, in the end, you're not able to do because government has got various ways of taxing you, isn't it? I mean, we all focus on direct taxes. How about indirect taxes, GST? At everything we buy, we are being taxed. So my request is, boss, forget about the tax part. Right now, just invest as much as possible to get maximum returns. Because if you're getting maximum return now, that will take automatically care of all the taxes, isn't it? But if you are just investing because you have some tax benefit, lousy, measly 2%, 3%, boss, that product is not poised for getting you good returns. This is just for tax benefit. And that is not what you're looking at, isn't it? Now, when we put money in savings schemes like NSS, LIC policies, ULIPs, here you are taxed properly. Remember that. So if you see this particular chart, what comes to your mind? In a way, the system is trying to push you from debt into equity, isn't it? So in a way, you're being pushed towards the edge of the cliff. My suggestion is, please, you have to, you know, somehow prop out your wings, learn how to fly. If you don't, remember, the cliff is very steep. You'll be getting back into that area wherein you don't want to come out from, isn't it? Which means in debt, there are no returns. Even schemes are not that friendly to us. But the moment you talk about equity, you've got areas where you can make a lot of profit. A lot of people have actually done that. Okay, so I'll give you another example. Now, look at this. Keeping rate of inflation, the rate has gone up. Okay, now if you invest 1 lakh rupees, okay, consider 1981 to be your year zero, your base year. Okay, and if you're investing 1 lakh rupees in Sensex, after 5 years, it becomes this much. PPF, it becomes this much. 5 year fixed deposit, this much. If you invest 1 lakh for 25 years, look at how much it has become here. Clearly, you see Sensex outstrips returns, isn't it? Last couple of 25, 30 years, if you see in the Sensex, market has grown like anything, isn't it? Which means equity gives you far better return. Sensex is actually the sensitive index of Bombay Stock Exchange. It's another exchange like National Stock Exchange. NSE has got Nifty. I'll give you another example. Say Nifty, when it started 95, 92, if I'm not wrong, Nifty was trading then around 800, 900. Today, Nifty is trading at around 11,000 something, isn't it? Tell me honestly, which sector has gone 11 times? This has, but we don't think about it because we are scared. Otherwise, we've got a lot many myths about this market. My request is, today's session is about debunking all these myths. Understand how this market works, and little knowledge can take you a lot way ahead, isn't it? Now, when we talk about stock market, you need to understand what is a share. The unit on which we're talking about is share only, right? Now, share is basically a certificate that is issued by companies which want to raise capital for their expansion or new business, okay? For that, they would be giving share certificate to people like you and me, and in return, they get per unit capital. Then money goes to the bank and it helps them to start new business or expansion, okay? Now, how do you buy a share? There are ways of buying. One is primary market, the other is secondary market. Secondary market, what happens is, the deal always happens between the buyer and the seller. Company is non-involved, remember that. Once the shares are issued by, there's nothing the company can do. Then it's secondary market. Here what happens is, there's a DP in between, depositary participant or broker, as we call it. Broker sees to it, he is taking the share from the person who wants to sell it and giving it to the buyer. He brokers that deal, isn't it? There's a contract paper. And then you've got depository in between, right? Understand something, share is not a normal product that, you know, you can just go to a company and say, Mr. Tata, I want to buy one share, please give me a share. This is my email ID, send it to me or DMAT account. No. You have to go through a DP. DP is a broker. He facilitates that whole process. And since they are complex products, we have got the whole system of financial market. Isn't it? Okay. How do we benefit from the market? See, we have invested in a stock, a particular stock of a company. Company grows, we'll be happy. Company doesn't grow, it becomes smaller, we'll be sad. Isn't it? So this is how market works. Now, dividend is a term we all come across. What is a dividend? Dividend is actually a share in the company's profit, which means total profit divided by number of shareholders. That is your dividend per unit. What happens is, whenever company expands, new business happens, they make a lot of money. Now, they have to remember people who have invested in the company. So what they do at the end of the quarter, year, they divide dividends. Many a times they might not distribute dividends, mind you. Then what happens is that money goes to the share value of the company. Then you have got capital appreciation. So there are two ways of making money. One is capital appreciation, the other is dividend of the company. Okay. Now, when a company wants to access the capital market, they have to go through an IPO. That is what we call primary market. IPO means initial public offering. First, what happens is a company has to release an offer document that comes in various newspapers, and then they have to submit their red herring prospectus, DRH as we call it, to the SEBI. SEBI would go through the accounts of the company bit by bit. And once SEBI sees the company is a decent company, the people's money would not go waste. And by doing all the keeping all the checks and balances in place, they give a go ahead to the company. Company will go with the merchant banker who will create valuation of the company, isn't it? They go to the depository, shares are issued on the exchange, it gets listed. And once it gets listed through DMAT account, the deal is done. Before, it used to be a huge long drawn process. Today, thanks to technology digitization, it's become even more simpler. Another beautiful aspect is ASBA. You know what, whenever we used to, before apply for IPOs, the money used to go to the company, stay there for some time. If your luck is there, if the company is not subscribed that many times, you'll still get number of shares. If it's subscribed many times, they will do, you know, go by lots. If they do by lots, you may or may not get, which means your money stays dormant. Now, a new thing has come through, that's called application supported by locked amount. Which means
Hello? Sir Pratyush Bhaskar, yes, I'm sorry for interrupting you, but we are running a little bit out of time.
I'll run through.
Yes. All right. Thank you. Okay.
So this is primary market. I'll just rush through this slide. This is rolling settlement, I think, sir, has taught you. It's just that, you know, before it just takes huge number of days today. From trading plus 2 days, you get money into your DMAT account, which means trading has become even more simpler and faster. If you want to buy through a stockbroker, secondary market, you need to open your basic services DMAT account, BSD we call it. You need PAN, Aadhaar card, a profile entry address, bank account for that. I'll just rush to it. Just the process requirement. These are features. In case if you are trading only 50,000 rupees, there are no charges AMC for your BSD. In case if you are trading for more than 50,000 to 2 lakh rupees, you still would be charged less than 100 rupees, which is decent enough. For trading, there are certain requirements you have to go through. Before, when you fill application form, you'll have to read through these things. Please don't leave any spaces blank. You never know what the broker will do there. Also, when you are trying to run through the market, there's a nice, beautiful aspect called single KYC securities market. Thanks to budget 2014-15, now what we have is single KYC. You don't have to run through different windows and get know your client, know your customer norms done. Today, through a single KYC, you can get all your KYC done. Okay. Now, when we invest in any company, you have to do through a stock broker. How do we know which broker is good enough. You have to go on SEBI website, check details about those, their registration, whether they're still or not. Check their track record. Check their membership that they are claiming that they are members to some stock exchanges. You have to see how they execute their orders. Do they have their own deposit service or not? And very importantly, whenever we try to open a demat account, remember documentation is very key. Read all the offer documents carefully, as they say. Okay. Now, remember, regarding investment, we have these various sayings that look at quality of business, not just stock, which is a fact. You should always know whether you want to, you are investing in the name, the brand, or the kind of business they are in. Check all these details. Please stay away from all these hot stocks, as they call it, you know. How much money will you make, you know? You should always have a vision in front of you, goal in front of you, you know. And when we invest, think about how market would behave. Never try to time the market. People have this funny notion that 20 years market will be there. Don't just research about the companies, research about the stocks, and then invest. Okay. Now, mutual funds, as I told you, basically they are managed by professionals. People like you and me pool our money. There's a common objective, and it's regulated by SEBI, the regulator. Okay. Now, there are three parts of mutual fund. You would have studied trustee, asset management company, and then there are schemes of mutual fund. And best of all, it's regulated by SEBI itself. Why do we invest in mutual funds? Very simple. Professionally managed, transparent liquidity. Whenever I want, I can redeem my units. It's convenient, small ticket size, diversified. Mutual funds invest across the board. It's well regulated and operational cost is very low. Okay. Difference between mutual fund and equity. They are different. People think they're one and the same. They're not. Remember, equity oriented mutual funds are there, which funds investing in equity stocks and shares. They are debt mutual funds investing in fixed income products like bonds and debentures. Like this, they've got different forms of mutual fund, and they're open-ended, closed-ended, double funds also. Now, there are two different products, just to give you an example. There was one which was an insurance called ULIP. It came through to provide best of both the world, that is invested in insurance. Believe me, sometimes people try to do that. Sometimes what has happened is people have got returns of insurance and safety of investment. They thought of getting the other way around, but it hasn't happened. So my request is, whenever you think of a particular product, do some research. Don't look at the product dossier, but look at the whole report. Okay, ETF is a wonderful product. It gives best of both the worlds, which means it gives you best of mutual fund as well as shares, which means it's like a mutual fund which is traded dynamically on the bourses. There's a continuous pricing and you have to sell and buy through a broker. Okay, now in ETF, you've got another beautiful product called gold ETF. We all love gold, isn't it? Now, but we all are scared about the theft, wealth tax, issues of purity is there, whether or not you get pure gold. So just to do away with all these concerns, we've got gold ETF, which means there's a third party which takes gold's ownership and he is trading on your behalf. You just have a small piece of paper like a contract, the way you've got a mutual fund. Only thing for that, gold is the underlying asset. Remember that. Which means tomorrow if the prices go up and you want to get benefit of that price arbitrage, you can just sell the piece of paper without touching the gold physically, without taking any of the risk involved. You can get good returns. Okay, so mutual fund is just like a mutual fund, but underlying asset is gold. Okay, now look at the benefits you get when you invest in gold ETF or fund of fund. You get wealth taxes not applicable here, long-term capital gain tax not after 1 year, VAT is not applicable here, which means whenever you invest, please kindly go through this particular chart. It's available on the website. Get proper information and then invest. Okay. Just last two slides. In case whenever you think about investment, as I said, never go by hearsay. If I am saying, boss, invest here, don't. Unlisted returns, like if somebody says on a 30-day contract, I'm giving 20% return. Don't believe. As I told you, there's nothing called easy money. Okay. Deals like land, real estate, doubling investment, teak plantation, emu farming, wood farm, they all sound very nice on the face, but remember that they're not recognized by SEBI. SEBI has to go through everything, and then there are a lot of frauds that have happened. Why? Because, you know, people didn't consult SEBI first. And that's the reason we always say, whenever you hear of something, go to SEBI helpline number. That's what I'm trying to share with you. Because investment is something that even Einstein would not dare getting into. He can talk about relativity, but investment has a different arithmetic altogether. When we think about filing a complaint to SEBI, there's a nice grievance redressal mechanism that you see in front of you. Online, you can go to this https://scores.gov. Click on this, you can file complaints. Okay. There are people in SEBI who speak all possible languages. They will help you with your problem. In case if you have any issues, you can call on the helpline number 1800-267-SENPED. These numbers are available from 9:30 to 5:30 in the evening. Please call them up Monday to Friday. They'll help you with whatever you want. In the case of Sahara, people called up. That's the reason they got their money back. So my request is, in Northeast, a lot of chit funds are operating, isn't it? Plantation schemes. Please approach SEBI. SEBI is just for you. In case if you want to visit the offices, they are here. The website, this is the one. And in case if you want many more such programs, you can click on this. You can mail it to them and they can give you many more such programs. I think this was the long and short of the session. I'm sorry if I did bore you, but I hope I've finished in time. Any questions?
Yes, if students have any question, participants, if you have got any questions, I think we can take one or two questions because we are actually running out of time. I'm sorry for that, sir. However, if there is anyone who has got any question, yes, we will take except one or two questions. So you may either type it in the chat or unmute your microphone and ask sir the question if there is any doubt.
Or what you can do, if you're short of time, you can mail me the question on rahmedia03@gmail.com. I'll make sure I answer your questions. We've got our colleague Palak is here. She's written this question. This email ID. You can mail your questions here. Okay.
Great. All right, sir. Then I think we'll have to go for that option. I'm really sorry for rushing you at the end.
Thank you so much for being in such huge numbers. Thank you so much. I appreciate you taking time off.
Yes. Thank you so much, sir. It has been
a great day, sir. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, sir, Patius, for coming in online and enlightening us on these capital markets. We have covered all the topics like mutual funds, stocks, shares, and then SIP, and then at age level, at what age level they need to invest. The more the age is, the less the risk takes. So at earlier, we need to invest in that way. So, and the book you say, told us, Robert Ecosia, even I want to show the students, this is the book. By business school,
yes.
All the commerce students, management should study these books once.
Please do,
okay?
Please do.
Business school, the same book, sir, now said, Cash Flow Quadrants and all, it's written by Robert T. Kawasaki. It's a wonderful book. You will know how to get invest, where to invest, and how can you you increase your investments value over the times. So when to invest, where to invest, and keep away from these chain marketings and like the
guys, you're lucky to have such a good professor. He knows everything. You know, you have an industry person. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah. So you need to be away from this. You should check with SEBI investing anything. Okay. So thank you, sir, for coming over here. We maybe because of Corona and pandemic, we're not invited in our college. Maybe
thank
next
you,
years, sure, you'll be coming over in our college. So thank you. Thank you. Once again, student, if you have any queries, you can just write in the chat box or just we are actually running today. Now we have one more session just started at 3 p.m. Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much for all the participants for joining in. I hope you have understood whatever sir has taught you today about shares, mutual funds, and how to not invest in Ponzi schemes, how to be careful, how to save your money, how to increase value of your money. Since we all are running out of time, I have shared one email ID. It's rahmedia03@gmail.com. Feel free to mail us any of your doubts or queries. Okay, and sir is there and our other trainers and experts are there to answer you. And we'll ensure to answer you as soon as possible. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you so much, sir Pratyush Bhaskar and the team. Thank you so much for what you have presented. It has been not only enlightening, but it has also been very interesting with the jokes and the, you know, the examples that you have given. Thank you so much for that. We have really enjoyed it. And yes, if there are any questions in future, we will definitely email it to rahmedia03@gmail.com. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you on behalf of Tetsuo College and the Department of Commerce and Management. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.
Thank you, your teammate also, sir. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Dr. Chico Saleh.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thanks.